Rhode Show Kitchen this morning. Chef Derek Wagner is here from Nick's on Broadway. We got Scup with roasted early spring vegetables on the menu. Good morning. Nice to have
you. Good morning. Good to see you. Nice to be back.
You know, I was telling you a little while ago that you can't go on like Instagram or one of these social media sites without seeing all of the great food that is made every single day at Nick's on Broadway. It really has become one of those restaurants that if you live in Rhode Island or come to Rhode Island, you need to go to visit.
Thank God for that, right?
Yeah, exactly.
We're very lucky in that way. So, you know, we just try to keep everything fresh and fun and make everything taste good. And it seems to be,
doing the job.
So, yeah. And it doesn't hurt when we have people coming in, taking pictures and posting them up there and getting everybody else excited about it.
And so. I see that all the time. One of the things you folks are really just famous for, other than the great presentation of the food, is the fresh food that you use, the fresh, you know, things that you place on the meal. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're going to do today, right?
Absolutely. Just lots of fresh early spring vegetables. All of them are sourced from different local farms.
Right.
And one of my favorite fish, scup, which is also known as porgy, indigenous of this part of the coast here, and very, very prevalent. It's a great fish to support.
To use.
Yeah,
to All right, so let's go over the ingredients and things that we're going to need to put this together.
So, of course, we need the scup.
Right.
Okay, it's a beautiful fish, great, lovely color. We've got lots of fresh spring veggies. We've got some kale, some New Zealand spinach, which is the varietal, not where it's from. Some rainbow shards, some pea greens, some fiddleheads, which are just one of the coolest.
I've had those before, and they really are good.
They're so tasty. Very fresh, vibrant. Some beautiful purple potatoes from Shartner's Farm. Carrots, onions, fresh parsley, and some other herbs. Rhode Island mushrooms. And some spring radishes.
All good stuff. And, you know, you're also going to be talking to us in just a little bit about the plant sale.
Absolutely.
That's going on at City Farm. Because we were talking, there are going to be 20,000.
20,000 different varietals of plants that they're going to be offering there for sale. And it's really, if you have never been there, it's really special to see this part of the spring. Everyone's getting their gardens ready.
Right.
You know, and you can go to some of the big stores and buy, you know, random plants or generic plants, but if you want some really special heirloom varietals, you've got to go
there. All right, so we're going to talk more about that because people are itching. Yeah. They are ready to get outside and start planting things for the summer as the weather gets so much nicer. Back to you.
Now let's send it back into the kitchen. Michaela, take it away.
Yeah, that's right. Chef Derek from Nick's on Broadway is here. Do you have a dog that can do any of those fun little...
I've got three dogs, and they do plenty of tricks, let me tell you. Nothing
probably
like,
just
nothing
all for
like
treats,
that, though.
Though
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Very food-motivated.
We're food-motivated this morning because you got a great recipe on the menu for us. What are we looking at here?
So the first step of this, really easy. We've just got some beautiful, beautiful early spring veggies, and all we've done is slice them up different shapes, and a little olive oil, salt, pepper, some fresh herbs, a little bit of lemon juice.
Mm-hmm.
Just squirt that on there. And then I've got a sprayed cookie sheet or baking sheet right here, and we're just gonna just set them on there, spread them out.
Okay.
And then pop them in the oven.
They will be going in shortly, but in the meantime, Southside Community Land Trust 23rd annual plant sale, that's coming up. Tell us about it.
It's incredible. I'm so proud to support Southside Community Land Trust. They do such incredible work. They've been helping low-income families and families in general just get access to inner city farmland and helping them educate and get the resources to do that. So this plant sale is one of their biggest annual fundraisers, and what they've got is over 20,000 plants, all different heirloom vegetable varieties.
Wow.
That they put out on City Farm, and you can go and you can buy some of the plants, such as these over here, different varieties of tomatoes and peppers and greens and onions, and it's really incredible.
It
all goes to a great cause.
When and where? What should we
Well,
know
I know
about
it's
that?
A Saturday. It's going to be the Saturday morning, and it goes from 10 to 2. And I know that if you are a member of Southside Community Land Trust, they give you a little pre-sale.
Awesome.
You know, so you can get in at 9 o'clock and get your pick of the litter. But it really it's just an open house there where you get to go through the farm and go shopping for plants. And
what a great opportunity to do
is.
So. You can get your gardens going and cash in on some great deals there. All right, don't forget, we still have the scup that we need to get to, and we will in just a bit.
Back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, Chef Derek Wagner is here from Nick's on Broadway. You know the place. You love it. A lot of Rhode Islanders go there all the time. I'm sure it'll be busy this this coming weekend with Mother's Day
here as well. Absolutely.
And this morning we got Scup with, roasted vegetables, fresh roasted vegetables on the menu.
So here we go. We're just going to take this beautiful, beautiful Scup filet, which I've just left the skin on because I like to cook fish that way. It helps it keep it together a little easier. We're just going to put some salt and pepper on there.
If someone out there has never had scup, what would you compare it to?
You know, one of the easiest fish for people to relate to is red snapper. A lot of people have had snapper, and it's very, very similar. Some people even call it silver snapper because it's so similar. But it's a really beautiful, mild, almost sweet fish. It gets very flaky when it cooks, and you can see it has that nice pinkish color, but as it cooks, that'll turn white. So people are always afraid to cook fish at home. They think it's going to stink up their house or it's going to take too long, and that's really not the case. You know, fish is actually one of the quickest things to cook.
Really?
You can make a mess, but you don't have to. So one of the things we do see as it starts to curl, really, really quick. We just put it in the pan, and we're just going to hold it down for a second here.
Now, why do you do that?
Well, as it cooks, you can see how it just contracts up a little, and we just hold it down, and you don't have to use your hands. You can use a spatula or a knife just to hold it in place, and that will keep the skin from curling up on you.
And peeling away from you.
Yeah, and really what we do is it does almost all the cooking on that one side. We've had the pan heating up slowly, so it's not snapping and popping and getting grease everywhere. And you can see it's nonstick, so that'll help it from tearing.
Isn't it
beautiful?
Sure.
So really, it's gonna go like that. We're just gonna let it brown up, and you can see how the flesh starts to turn colors. Mm-hmm. You can see that whitish gray starting to poke up over there, and that's what we're looking for. So we let that go. We've got our vegetables in the oven. And then just on the side, we're going to just do a little wilted greens. Some just really lightly.
Okay.
Take some onions. Okay. Again, really quick, simple. Very fresh. Some kale.
Love kale.
Nice. Yeah,
there's some beautiful New Zealand spinach from one of my favorite farmers, Leanne, from Indy Growers. I got some chard from Chardner's Farm, and also some pea greens from Debbie.
You're mentioning all these local places.
I got a lot of friends.
Well, you mentioned getting all of these local ingredients, and that brings up the plant sale
exactly.
Once again. You can get all of these local things.
And that's one of the things that we try to do at the shop is just to have these connections with, look at that, oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
Support each other
and really offer you as a guest some of the freshest, most delicious food
around
that you can get, but also
really
support our local community and give back a little bit and make connections with the farmers.
And this plant sale is going to be a big deal. You had 20,000 plants.
20,000.
People wanted to get, and you brought some of the plants.
We've got some.
They really are. They're hardy. They're healthy looking plants. They're really great looking.
And this is a fun time of the year, okay, because it's still early spring, so nothing is really popping. We've still got a lot of root veggies here.
Right.
And some basically just green veggies that are starting to come in. But it's exciting because all the plants are just starting to bloom and pop. And so we're seeing some of the tomatoes, and this is when people want to get their gardens going.
Sure.
So
definitely.
This is a perfect time to go
get
to the plant
there
sale
it.
And
sure.
get
now,
in there.
Now, how are our veggies doing? Are those
Our veggies are doing pretty good.
Okay.
Want me to check them?
Yeah, let's check them.
I got it.
You're going to be my sous chef today?
You snag those.
Look so good.
Oh, yeah.
They look so good.
They're just getting in there, nice and fresh, beautiful.
All right, if you want this recipe, head on over to rhode show.com.